The New York Times has sued OpenAI and Microsoft for copyright infringement over unauthorized use of its published work to train AI technologies. This could have implications for all of us. The lawsuit alleges that the companies used millions of Times articles to train automated chatbots that are now competitors. The Times is demanding billions in statutory and actual damages and wants chatbot models using its copyrighted material destroyed. This landmark case could redefine the legal landscape of generative AI technologies and potentially put users in the crosshairs. This is critical to understand. Cecilia Ziniti, an IP and AI lawyer, broke it down on X, saying, "It's the best case yet alleging that generative AI is copyright infringement, and it could be a watershed moment for AI and copyright." Sharing screenshots from the filing, she showed the comparative output between ChatGPT and actual text from the New York Times, revealing word-for-word outputs and saying it would be smarter for OpenAI to settle than fight. She might be right, because the New York Times brought receipts after negotiations broke down over many months with OpenAI. Leading AI expert Gary Marcus also pointed out that the prompts that elicited the plagiarism in no way requested that the system draw on the New York Times at all. But what does this mean for users of generative AI, including businesses and the general public? Well, there are four things you need to know urgently. The fourth is the most important of all, and I've got a free chapter from my brand new book, The Wolf is at the Door, How to Survive and Thrive in an AI-Driven World, for you below, to help you prepare for 2024. But first, The Guardian reported in November that OpenAI CEO Sam Altman will defend customers and pay the costs incurred if they face legal claims around copyright infringement. This includes ChatGPT Enterprise and API. Notably, however, it didn't include users of the free version of ChatGPT or ChatGPT Plus, which could expose enterprises and individuals to lawsuits if staff do not understand the new dynamics. Second, I suspect that we will see AI models in 2024 developed to crawl the internet to find out who is reproducing copyrighted material, and there will be a flood of lawsuits. Businesses and users may inadvertently reproduce content from sites like the New York Times. So here's my recommendation. If you're using generative AI, run it through a plagiarism checker before hitting publish, as there could be a run on lawsuits to make money on copyright claims. And speak to an IP lawyer if your staff is using it. Third, this lawsuit could pave the way for writers, publishers, and creators to finally be compensated for their work that has been used to train these models. A version of this model was introduced in Japan with Alt Inc. becoming the world's first company to pay salaries to employees' AI clones, something I predicted in my new book months ago. Lastly, this lawsuit could force OpenAI and other platforms like Midjourney to reveal their training data, opening a huge can of worms and slowing down AI's progress. This may lead to companies needing to train their own AI models on their proprietary content. But will that proprietary content be used in others' outputs like it has in this case? New security measures will have to be put in place and the risk assessed. The bottom line is this. This is a landmark lawsuit that could have huge implications for the future of generative AI, and most are simply unprepared to navigate it. Download the free chapter from my new book, The Wolf is at the Door, that explores the threats and opportunities of an AI-driven world. Trust me, you're gonna need it.